What's up guys, Ahmed here, and in this video, I'm going to be objectively reviewing these two awesome books. I only have the Egyptian Arabic version now, I don't have the other one in print. They're great books, I love them. I wonder who the author is. Me? Okay. Okay, jokes apart. Let me share with you how the idea of this book came. But first, let's see what my students Amin and Yi think of the book.
بجد انا بحب الكتاب قوي عشان اتعلمت كلمات جديده كتير و how to say expression تعبيرات مفيده. في اول كنت فاكره الكتاب ممكن هيبقى صعب ليا عشان نيوز يعني خبر بالعربي. انا كنت خايفه شويه خبر ممكن ممل, بس ده مش حقيقه. الكتاب طلع كويس جدا, في قصه شيقه. الكتاب عباره عن قصه مثلا عن الصحه, عن حياه يوميه. اول قصه ليا كانت كورونا برجر. جميل جدا بجد.
احمد, انا اريد ان تقول لك انا احب كتابك. عندي اثنين, واحد من الاخبار في مصري والخير من اخبار في الفصحى, وانا ادرس كل اليوم الكتابة واحبها, افهم كثيرا وأدرس كثيراً وعرى المختلفة. أنا أفهم أكثر كثيراً. جميل. شكراً للكتابك.
Let me share with you how the idea of this book came. Matthew Aldrich, my co-author and the founder of Lingualism.com, saw a few articles, news articles that I had made for my intermediate and advanced students. He liked the idea and suggested we make 25 of these and put them in a book. And this is what we did. We made this book last year. Then, after getting feedback, Matthew suggested we also translate the book into MSA, Fusha, Modern Standard Arabic. And for those who are studying MSA and Egyptian Arabic, for instance, and want to learn by comparing, or those who have been learning MSA and want to make a translation to Egyptian Arabic, or vice versa, there's a limited time 10% off on the MSA version. Use the code NMSA, NMSA, at checkout to get the discount. I'll also leave a link below that will get you 15% off if you buy the two books together. As for the Egyptian Arabic version, I must tell you that this is something that I have never seen before. This is not something that you will see. The news in newspapers is written in MSA. So even for those who already speak Egyptian Arabic, like Egyptians themselves, would find it a bit strange to read news in Egyptian Arabic. As for the Fusha version, I didn't really do the translation myself. Lilia Khashroom was kind enough to do it, and I was kind enough to do the editing. I also recorded the articles with my lovely voice. Speaking of my lovely voice, I must say that, in case you haven't already noticed that I don't make clear S and Z sounds. So I'm not sure, should I have let someone else do the recording? I don't know, maybe you can let me know in the comments below. Okay, let's start with the design and how the book is laid out. The Egyptian Arabic version is in blue, while the MSA version is yellow-ish. I personally prefer the blue version. Also, the fonts are different in the MSA version, and the color of the diacritics is different. The font in MSA is more like what you will find in an actual newspaper. It looks more serious, I would say. But the colors are only in the PDF version, which is also compatible with Kindle. This version, the paperback version, is black and white. It feels really nice in the hand. The material of the papers and the cover are good. So except for this kid on the cover, I would say the design is fine to me. The book consists of 25 articles, as I said. Also, the articles fall under different categories, and also each article is labeled in the color of the category it falls under. The way you will see each article is that you will find it first with a picture here and no diacritics. This is more or less the way you will find it in an actual newspaper. And then you will find a keywords section. What's neat is that you will find the words defined in Arabic, and then the translations are left so that you can choose from, like, you have the translations under at the end, at the bottom of the page, and you should match the English translations with the correct word, ideally after reading the definitions. But honestly, sometimes the definitions are harder than the words themselves, and this is the case in any one language dictionary. A three-year-old English boy would know the word beautiful, but probably not the word aesthetically. That's in the definition. What's aesthetically anyway? I'll look that up later. So I suggest you start matching the easier words. This way you will have fewer options to play with. And in case you don't know all the words are difficult, just go ahead and check the answers in the answer key and translations section. And just ignore the Arabic definition. If you already know all the words on the vocab list, then reading the definitions will just add to your vocabulary. Anyway, then you will find the story written with tashkil, with diacritics. Then you will find comprehension questions and then discussion questions. And here we have expressions and structures. Basically, you have like expressions or structures that are taken from the actual article. Each one will be written four times and only one of them is correct, and you should try to guess and remember which one is the correct one. And then of course you can check your answers in the answer key and translations section. And this takes us to the answer key and translation section. Here you will find first the translations of the vocabulary and then the translation of the article. And in the translation, I put literal meanings, some literal meanings, between brackets. And then between parentheses, you will find things that are necessary in English, but you will not find them in the Arabic text when comparing. I thought this would be helpful for self-study, for those who would like to compare and see which word in Arabic means what in English. And also, a lot of people are interested in the literal meanings of some things, because of course different languages often express the same concepts differently. Then you have phonemic transcription, and the phonemic transcription is only in the Egyptian Arabic version. And the phonemic transcription, in my opinion, is not only helpful for those who don't know Arabic script. Even if you know Arabic script, it's helpful because it shows you how things change, how words change based on where they are within the sentence, or how a word would sound like when read along with other words. The most common question I get about the phonemic transcription is this upside down E. This is called a schwa, and it's only pronounced when you read a word that has this schwa at the end with the next word together. An example, Masr, Masr, Egypt, doesn't have eh at the end. But when you read it with the next word, Ahsan, you will add a short eh in the middle. You will say Masr, Masr, Ahsan. But when you read the word Masr on its own, you don't see this eh at the end. Of course, the phonemic transcription and the writing, the Arabic writing, follow the lingualism system. So I'm just letting you know, in case you wonder why I write some words a little bit differently in my videos, for example, or other material that I create. And finally, we have this section called notes, where you can obviously take notes. And that's really the book. Okay, who is this book for? The book is mainly aimed at those who are already comfortable making basic conversations and want to take their conversation skills to the next level and want to be able to discuss or understand Arabs when they discuss the news. Because of course, the news is written in Fusha, but nobody discusses it in Fusha. For example, on talk shows or when you speak to an Arab, you will not use Fusha, of course. So the book will help you bridge this gap between newspapers and written texts and what you can actually use in conversation. This, of course, applies to the Egyptian Arabic version. The MSA version will be useful for anyone who wants to understand the news in general. And as I said earlier, for those who want to compare, because you have the same topics, the same stories written in two different varieties of Arabic, and this will hopefully be interesting and useful to you. But you can still go to lingualism.com and download a free sample, which is going to be like a full story. You will also get access to all the audio recordings for free, so you can just see the sample, listen to the recording, and check whether the book is the right fit for you. the book is not perfect, but we did our best, and inshallah, my future work will be better and better. And by the way, I found some minor typos, my bad, of course, but we're collecting them and we will correct all of them once we have like a big number of these. In case you find any, let us know. And that was it. Thank you so much for watching the video. You can follow me on social media for the other content that I create. And if you're interested in taking online classes, check the link below. Shukran. Salam.